we're here in Moscow.
Moscow.
At a big flea market. Apparently this park, we're right next to a gigantic park that's 16 square kilometers that was the private stomping grounds of the Romanovs for about 400 years, and now it's open to public. Here's the thing, I don't know why everybody's so sad about the Romanovs. The Romanovs were, everybody gets really sad about them because they got killed off by the communists and the whole thing, you know, Anastasia got away. And so, I don't know why everybody, Catherine was bad and killed lots of people, and I don't know why everybody's so sad about them, and now why the whole country wants to revert to like a sort of like a fake ideology that existed 120 years ago, but everybody's sort of going back to this weird like Russian identity that that way as if they had a king, but they don't have a king anymore, so nobody knows what the Romanovs kind of creepy. It's awesome. I love the Romanovs. What? Peter the Great was the first of the Romanovs and was great. Catherine the Great was not great. That Ivan the Terrible, I guess in Russian, terrible is actually more like awesome, and so it's kind of weird because he was terrible, but he also beat. Was it the Poles or the Tatars he beat?
Yeah.
Okay. What we really got to get to here quickly is that everybody here is sad. Everything oozes sadness, and it's noble sadness. Everybody they know they have to be miserable, and that is the only currency of life is misery. It's just like the subcurrent of everything, it runs under everything, and nobody can be happy in public, and they can be happy privately. We think you're not allowed to go up to a stranger and ask them questions on the street.
No,
freaks them out. The little old ladies at the stalls, they can be nice to you and they can laugh a little bit. So you know that there is joy in their eyes and hearts sometimes, but mostly there's just public misery.
Okay.
Did we cover it all?
What do you got any more questions over
there?
That's
all there is to say.
Okay, and this is our friend who's at the table. Say hi. No, that's not gonna happen. And David.
That's a pretty good example of what we're talking about.
Thank you very much.